Hello friends, welcome to TextStudyCell. In this video, we are going to make a complete home automation system using the Blynk IoT platform. And apart from Blynk, you can also control all the appliances and the fan speed with Bluetooth, IR remote and manual switches. Although I have used a PCB, but you can make this complete project without using any PCB. So I will highly recommend you to watch the complete video as I have shared the circuit source code during the video, and after watching it, you can easily make this project. First, let me try to control this light with the Blynk. Let me turn it off. Now let me turn it on. Then I will try to control the fan with the Blynk. So let me turn the fan on. You can see fan starts rotating, and I can also increase the fan speed with this slider. The speed increased, and I can use this button to turn off all the appliances together. Now let me go to the Bluetooth app. So here you can see it is connected, so I can also control the appliances with this app. Let me press this button to turn on all the appliances. You can see the fan, light, everything turns on, and I can also increase or decrease the fan speed with these buttons. So let me make the speed 1. You can see the speed is 1 right now. Now let me try to control this light. Let me turn it off, and if I press this button, the lights will turn on. On the PCB, you can see this blue LED is glowing, which indicates now the ESP32 is connected with the Blynk server. So let me turn off the Wi-Fi to show you how it works without internet. Now the ESP32 is not connected with the Wi-Fi, so let me use this IR remote to control the appliances. You can see I can easily control all the appliances, and with these two buttons I can increase or decrease the fan speed. Now let me reduce the fan speed with this button, and I can also use these switches to control the appliances, and you can also use this regulator to control the speed manually, and this is the switch for the fan. Let me turn it off. Now let me turn on the Wi-Fi again. After turning on the Wi-Fi, you can see ESP32 automatically reconnects with the Blynk server, and I will recommend you to use PCB for this type of project. And now you can easily design professional PCBs using the Altium PCB Designer software. Altium is the most trusted PCB designer software by all the big electronic companies. With Altium, you can easily search any electronics components, compare the datasheet, and it has lot of useful features which will save you a lot of time while routing any complex PCBs. There are lot of tutorials available on Altium, and the user interface is so simple. You can easily learn this software and use it to design PCBs for your upcoming project. I will highly recommend you to download the free trial version of the Altium PCB Designer software from the video description. These are the required components for this project. Now if you don't want to use this PCB, then you have to connect all these components as per the circuit diagram. In the circuit, I have given the 5-volt supply to the ESP32 relay module and the Bluetooth module. You can use any other Bluetooth module, BLE module. If you are using 3.3 volt BLE module, then you have to connect the VCC pin with the 3.3 volt pin of the ESP32. I have already explained this circuit in my previous video. Now if you want to use PCB, then you have to refer this circuit to connect the appliances with the PCB. We are going to use this PCB for this project. Here I have to connect the ESP32. Then here I have to connect the Bluetooth module. But before that, if you are using any 3.3 volt Bluetooth module, you have to place the jumper here. Now here I am using a 5 volt Bluetooth module, HC05. So let me connect the VIN pin with 5 volt. Now I will connect the Bluetooth module, and here I have to connect the IR receiver. And with this pin, I have to connect the selector switch for the fan regulator. Now we will quickly configure the Blynk cloud. So let me log into my Blynk account. Then I will go to template. First, we have to create a template. So I will click on new template. Give a name to this template. Hardware will be ESP32. Connection type will be Wi-Fi. Now I will click on done. So our template is created. Now I will go to data stream tab. And here I will click on new data stream. Then select virtual pin. So for the first data stream, I will give the name switch 1. Then in the pin, I will select V1.
data type will be integer, and here the minimum value is 0, maximum value is 1, and default value will be 0. Now I will click on create. In a similar way, let me create 5 data stream. For the 5th data stream, I am giving the name fan, as we will turn on and off fan with this data stream, and in the pin I will select V5. Now we will create a 6th data stream to control the fan speed. Again I will select virtual pin. Here I will give the name fan speed, and in the pin I will select V6, and here minimum value will be 0 and maximum value will be 4, and default value will be 0. Now I will create a last data stream to turn off all the appliances together. So let me give the name all off, and in the pin I will select V7, then click on create. Now if you want, you can also define some automation. Now let me go to web dashboard. Here I will drag and drop 5 switch widget, and then I will drag and drop a slider. Now I will go to setting of each widget and select the data stream. Let me give the name switch 1 for the first widget. Then I will select the data stream switch 1. Then I will click on save. In a similar way, I will select the data stream for all the widget. After that, I have to save the template, so I will click on save. So our template is ready. Now we will add device with this template. For that, I will go to device, then click on new device, then select from template. Here we have to select the template we have just created, ESP32 Blynk. Here you can also give the name for that device. I am keeping as it is. Now click on create. So if I go to device info, here you can see you will get all the details required for coding. These are the source codes for this project. You can download all these codes from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article. You can find a link in the description. Then you can download all the codes from these buttons. After downloading, you can use this code to get the hex code of any IR remote buttons. I have already explained the process in my previous video. And this is the main sketch. Let me open this code. In this code, I have mentioned all the required libraries and the ESP32 board version I have used. So please install this version of these libraries and the ESP32 board to avoid any error. Then first, we have to update the template ID, device name and authentication token. So let me go to Blynk account. I will just click here to copy all these details, and here I have to paste it. Then I have to enter the Wi-Fi name and the Wi-Fi password. Then you have to update the hex code of the IR remote buttons. But if you purchase this complete project from us, you don't have to update the hex code, as we are also sending the IR remote along with this project. So if you refer the same circuit, you just have to update these details. After that, you can directly upload this code to ESP32 board. So in the board, you have to select the do it ESP32 dev kit v1, then select the proper port, then hit the upload button. In the code, I have used these GPIO pins for this project, and I have used these two GPIO pins for the serial communication. Now let me go to the void setup. So in the void setup, with this line, I can initiate the serial communication with the Bluetooth module. And here I am opening a namespace to save the last GPIO states. Now let me go to void loop. In the void loop, with these lines, we can control the appliances from manual switch. Now let me go to this Bluetooth control function, which I have used to control the appliances through Bluetooth. In the Bluetooth control function, first we are checking if there is any data available at serial 2 terminal. So if there is any data, we are comparing that data with the predefined value and accordingly turn on and off the relays. So if you go through the code, you can easily understand. Still, if you face any issue, you can always let me know in the comment section. After programming the ESP32, you can see this blue LED is glowing, which indicates now it is connected with the Blynk server. So let me open the Blynk IoT app, then select the ESP32 Blynk device which you have added. Now we will configure the mobile dashboard. For that, first I will add 5 button widget. Now let me resize the last button widget, which I will use for the fan. Then I will again tap on this plus icon and add a slider to control the fan speed. Then again I will tap on the plus icon and add last button widget to turn off all the appliances together. Now I will tap on the first button widget
and in the data stream I have to select the switch 1 data stream, and the mode will be switch. Now I will exit from this button widget. In a similar way, I have to configure first 5 button widget. Now I will tap on this slider widget, and here I will select the data stream fan speed. Now I will tap on the last button widget, which I will use to turn off all the appliances together. So here I will select the data stream all off, and here the mode will be push. So I will not change the mode. Now I will exit from it, and our dashboard is ready. Let me exit from the edit mode. Now let me quickly install the Bluetooth app. So I will go to my files, APK, then I have to install this app. You can download this app from the video description. Now let me open this app. Now before using this app, you have to give the permission to this app. So let me go to setting. Then here I will go to apps, then apps management. Then I will select the Bluetooth switch app which you have just installed. Then under the permission, I have to give the nearby device permission so that it can search for the Bluetooth device. Now I will exit from it. Then I will turn on the Bluetooth. First we have to pair the HC05 Bluetooth module. So I will tap on the HC05, then enter the password, which is 1234. You can also see the password here. Now tap on pair. After pairing, I will go to our Bluetooth app, which is Bluetooth switch. Then I will tap on connect, and under this list I will tap on the HC05, and here it is showing connected. So now if I tap here, you can see all the appliances turn on, and with this I can turn off all the appliances.
Now we have to connect this PCB with all the appliances as per this circuit. Now our home automation system is ready. So this is a very useful IoT project you can easily make for your home. So if you find this video helpful, then please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.